Hello everyone and welcome to this new video. Well, as you might have seen yesterday, we had a very tough match against UC Jamuli. We couldn't manage to win and unfortunately we've got away with the draw, only. And we sit here in the league, and today we're about to prepare our next match, which is going to be very, very difficult. As you can see, we're about to play against Jackal Football Club. They sit here in the league, fourth place, well deserved. Lots of goals scored, as many goals conceded as we have. So, yeah, very tough. Very, very tough. But let's see if we can make anything out of it. And in order to make our... Well, just wait, I've got an idea. In order to make this thing more sensible, let's just go and have a look at the fixtures. Fixtures, and while they load, we'll go away. So, Jackal Football Club, they have a very compact lineup, very thick midfield, as you can see, very skilled players, not immensely high with routine, but they're just too strong. Five stars. Then we've got four and a half stars here. Yeah, four and a half here, everywhere. They're just too strong. They're just too strong for us. And the only thing that might let them down is the routine of some of their players. Of course, not the goalkeeper. So, do you know what? This guy's too strong for us. The defending midfielders. They're too strong. They're just too strong. Central midfielder as well. So, in my honest opinion, we don't have to play this match. We have to go and try to get a draw. And we'll do this by going very defensive. But first, let's have a look at our next matches. So, Jackal Football Club, Bellocasone 1988 will be the following one, even stronger, and then we'll have Partenope, probably not as strong but nearly. They've got a very good team apparently, and then Vetim. So yeah, two strong teams. From now on, the next four matches will be just impossible to win. Core Milan will probably be the next one that we might actually at least draw or even win. Then I didn't have a look at their team, but this is what the standings tell me. Then they might not mean very much, but still, at this point of the season, they still don't mean a lot, but they do mean something, in my opinion. So we'll have to prepare to lose or to draw the next matches. We'll do it like so. Today we'll try and go with a pure B team. Well, except for Tatheo, no, I might actually keep him. So let's go with Egger. And then Torrione as a winger on the bench. Then we'll go with Fischnaller here. Quiricone has to play, he's got to make up some routine. And then we'll go, well, I'd rather keep this kind of defense because we have to have them more experienced. And then I'd go with well, let's keep Quiricone. Let's swap Cancelli though. Yeah, let's swap Cancelli as well. Let's go for La Camera, central midfielder here. And then we'll go for sorry. Variopinto here in the middle. And then we'll go with Passeri, of course, who needs a lot of routine, and Storari. Storari will go very defensive and with long balls. Hopefully this is going to do some tricks, at least it's going hopefully to earn us a draw. So let's have a quick look at who might actually kick the corner kicks. We've got Variopinto. He seems quite suitable for this. So for free kicks, and then for corner kicks. No, the theater is there. The theater is there. So corner kicks, and then penalty kicks are going to be kicked by Passeri, probably. No, not him. Not him either. Definitely not. And then Quiricone, probably. No. No. No way. So let's go for Storari. He might actually get something out of it. And then our captain could be Fisnella, couldn't he? Let's just, well, the captain, I will choose it afterwards, guys, because given the kind of hardware I'm working with, it's going to take a while to scout all of the players looking for a suitable captain. So I'm not going to bore you away with this. And very defensive, long balls, focus side balanced, it's fine. Well, we should be playing on the wings because our opponents are yes, let's try it. Wings. Alright, hopefully this is going to earn us a few corner kicks. And yep, I believe this was the whole of it. We're not meant to do anything more than this, I'm afraid. And what we're doing is we're trying to exploit this match as much as possible in order to have all of these guys make up some experience and try not to and they'll probably be able to get a draw. Well, I'm definitely not sure we're playing with a B team, and our A team would be very likely to lose anyway. So I'm not sure if this is a good plan, but I believe it's not the right time to waste our good players on such helpless matches. As you can see, we've got an injured player for the next three matches, and I don't want the other players to be injured when it counts. So really, let's try and get this kind of team going, and then we'll have anyway the time if any of these got either disqualified or injured to replace them, and probably to promote some players from the B team if needed. So I think this is the best way to go at the moment. Some of you might be quite a bit disappointed. You might want to see your favorite team fighting for the victory, but this is not the time to do so. We'll be able to fight for victories when all of these guys will be up to speed with the routine and with the skills, of course, as well. So let's go for this, and hopefully tonight we'll be able to get at least a draw. I'm not that confident with it, but let's cross our fingers, guys. Thanks a lot again for watching, of course, and see you in the next video. Bye.